Medical technology has two tiers. We can fix that, and we can't fix that. Soon, spinal cord injuries might be on the good list. Hey everybody, I'm Trace, and you are plugged in to DNews. When human nerves are damaged, they don't regenerate. Regeneration is different from healing, by the way. Healing leaves scars, but regeneration returns the tissue to the pre-injured state. We're relatively low on the regenerative scale. Our skin, toes, fingers, ribs, liver, pancreas, kidneys, and smooth muscles are able to heal or regenerate. Nerves, neurons, skeletal muscles, and the heart, they all grow to a certain size and then stop. Some of the most devastating injuries involve long-term trauma and paralyzation of these non-regenerative tissues. When nerves in the spinal cord are severed, the brain's commands never reach the muscles in your legs. It's like losing power to your house because of a downed power line during a storm, but in humans, we didn't used to be able to put that line back up. But what if we could now? Lower vertebrates like the sea lamprey have regenerative nerves and spinal cords. Why do they get all the luck? Their brains are itty-bitty. Well, it has to do with a growth factor affecting the reticulospinal neurons in their brainstem. The cells transmit messages on movement, and when the University of Missouri researchers hit the cells with a natural molecule called cyclic AMP, the cells would begin to grow. The cells which were already growing just ignored it. No side effects at all. Researchers have been looking for factors like this, which appear in humans as well. We're hoping that we have them, but our DNA maybe had switched them off for some reason. A study in Nature Communications found just that, a protein called P300-CPB-associated factor, which we'll call PCAF. It seems to kick off the regeneration in mice. With this discovery, we might be able to regrow nerve cells in human peripheral nervous systems and central nervous systems, maybe. When researchers introduced PCAF, epigenetic factors switched on the regeneration mechanisms in cells, causing 30% of the nerves to grow back. Epigenetics, for those who don't know, is a process that can switch genes in the body on and off without actually altering the DNA physically. This discovery is one more step on the way to regrowing spinal cords after an injury, but it's really only part of the battle. Another study in the Journal of Neuroscience released this week also used as gene therapy to fight spinal injury. Researchers knew the enzyme chondroitinase ABC, or CHABC, will digest scar tissue on nerves. But administering it to the spine was really painful, and the enzyme dissipated really quickly, so you had to have a lot of treatments, not a lot of fun. So they taught the cells to produce their own using gene therapy. Gene therapy involves injecting a reprogrammed retrovirus into the spinal cord cells to alter their cellular DNA directly. In this case, it programmed the spinal cord matrix to release CHABC itself. Thus, with only one injection of CHABC, the cells began to produce their own. The study was done in rats, and 12 days after this injection, they were up and walking around with scar-free spinal cords. It sounds like a miracle, but it's just science, guys. Let's get this in humans, though, okay, guys? How do you feel about this? Excited for the future? Tell us below, and subscribe over here somewhere for more awesome stories all about your world every day of the week. Come find us on Twitter if you have questions. I'm at Trace501, or you can go to DNews at DNews.